should go all the way, should go all the way, yes. Good result for Dumini and the Trident, Hero Maximum.
And the timing. And this is JP Dumini at his best, not that short, picks up on it.
Bang on the Republic Bank fan stand. JP Dumini finding the middle of his bat. The second time, Hero Maximum for him.
Quick hands from Dumini. Just gets onto that back foot quickly and takes advantage of a drag down slow ball.
And again.
Yeah, the little man's on the charge now. He's got his tail up, and that is a brilliant shot over extra cover. As good as you're going to see.
Goes full, goes straight. And Dumini has the skill to get a boundary. Straight. Bang! Another one for Dumini.
Well, I thought he hit a long golf ball when I played with him yesterday, but this is something exceptional. This is JP Dumini, the old JP Dumini. He's got his tail up and he's going. Ali Khan's under serious pressure. It's another full toss and it's another attempt at a one-handed catch.
Goes through the offside. Immaculate timing. This guy's on fire. And again, my word, JP Dumini can do anything wrong tonight.
To back of the hand, slower ball, he picks it up quite magnificently. Posits that way over mid-on.
And again, that's it, that's the record for the fastest 50 ever in CPL. Dumini, excellence tonight.
Well, he talks about his new carefree attitude, international cricket off his shoulders, and he's really enjoying his cricket. And it means so much to him. He's played with freedom, he's played with power, and he's hit a lot of these Hero Maximums.
And in doing so, he has recovered his side's hopes of having a competitive total.
Dumini, we've discussed the fact that you were going to play a role in this team to be the elder statesman. You've only gone and had the fastest CPL 50 of all time. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Yeah, very pleased with that batting performance after, you know, as a group, we've been discussing a lot in this tournament about putting a big effort in. So we set the game up nicely. That opening partnership really set the game up for us. You know, coming into this game with probably 10 batters, we could risk a few early on there, sort of in the middle phases. So for me, it was just about seeing the ball quite clearly, understanding what the bowler was trying to do and just trying to execute.
JP, wickets fell all around you. It was a good opening stand, but then three really quick wickets. And then you proceeded to destroy the bowling, 65 off 20, massive strike rate.
Yeah, I guess the benefit we had was we lost our first wicket, I think in the 12th or 13th over. So we lost three wickets, yes, but when I sort of identified, right, it's time to go, there were 16 gone already. So that's generally in a T20 game, you're going to try and take it on anyway. So the game was set up nicely for us.
Can you talk me through the Jimmy Neesham over?
Yeah, I've obviously faced him quite a few times in international cricket, so I understand what he's trying to do, particularly against me. He's had one over me a few times in international cricket, so it was good to get one over him tonight.
Well, it's a big number. It would be the highest ever run chase to be achieved here. How do you go about defending it?
Yeah, there's still a little bit in that wicket there. It's a little bit on the slow side. We've seen in the first two games how the wicket slows up in the back half of the game. So we've got to use that to our advantage coming the second innings.
Best of luck. Well done.
Thank you.